Polycystic ovarian syndrome, also called PCOS, causes both emotional and physical pain for a lot of women. It's a complex issue that involves no less than four main hormones. Two of those hormones are too high, but another two are too low. By the end of this video, you'll know exactly which hormones are high and which are low. More importantly, you'll have four practical steps to move you towards solving your PCOS concerns and relieving that emotional and physical pain. I'm Steve Goldring from SimpleHormones.com. I help patients and healthcare practitioners with easy to understand patient education resources. Most of those resources are about hormone optimization. I help women in menopause and perimenopause, men with low T, patients with thyroid problems, and women with PCOS. These are women who struggle with a long list of different symptoms, things like weight gain they just can't seem to shake, missed periods that are really an indication that they don't ever ovulate, at least not regularly. The fact that women don't ovulate means that they have a really hard time getting pregnant. PCOS is really the leading cause of infertility. In addition to that, PCOS can cause unwanted hair growth, masculinization effects. There's also painful periods and PMS symptoms that can be associated with it. Some women have velvety patches of skin called acanthosis nigricans on their neck or their shoulders. Acne and other skin problems are an issue. All these symptoms and more are hormone related. PCOS can be boiled down to a complex problem involving four different hormones. There are more hormones involved, but these four are the most important. Two hormones are actually low in PCOS. The first is thyroid. Thyroid hormones are kind of like orchestra conductors for your whole body. They get their hands in almost every system in your body. If your thyroid levels are low and you're a woman between, say, 15 and 45, that can contribute to PCOS on its own. Low thyroid makes PCOS worse in at least two ways. Low thyroid levels directly affect the ovaries, causing them to kind of grow and swell and develop what are called cysts. Low thyroid also encourages something called insulin resistance that we'll talk about a little bit later. Low progesterone might be considered a cause or a result of PCOS. The main place where progesterone comes from is something called the corpus luteum. That's tissue left over inside the ovary after ovulation. But if a woman doesn't ovulate, then there's no corpus luteum there to produce progesterone. So there's not really a great source for your body to get progesterone from, and the body can't really make it very well. Low progesterone can lead to something that's called estrogen dominance. Because your estrogen level is probably pretty high, there's basically too much estrogen in relation to the progesterone. So we've looked at hormones that are too low in PCOS, but there are two hormones that are too high in PCOS. The first is testosterone. That's high in almost all cases of PCOS. A woman's ovaries normally make testosterone. That's a good thing. Testosterone helps your bones stay strong. It gives you muscle strength. It helps you maintain a healthy sex drive. If testosterone is too high, that's what causes some of the masculinization symptoms in PCOS, like unwanted hair growth, hair loss, or male pattern baldness, some weight gain issues, a deepening voice. There's strong evidence that the ovaries produce higher than normal levels of testosterone in PCOS, mostly due to increased levels of another hormone that's often too high in PCOS, and that is insulin. High testosterone and other testosterone-like hormones are one of the main criteria for diagnosing PCOS. So if you have high testosterone, it's a major red flag that you also have PCOS. Also included in these diagnostic criteria are irregular periods, especially longer than 35 days or 8 periods a year, along with cysts on the ovaries. The biggest hormone factor in PCOS, though, is high insulin. Insulin, as you may know, is designed to move glucose from your blood into your cells. Over the long term, insulin might stop working the way it's supposed to. And when that happens, your pancreas keeps releasing more and more insulin, but it starts working less and less. That's called insulin resistance. It's one of the root causes of PCOS. Insulin resistance leads to high insulin, but the insulin doesn't work, as I mentioned. High insulin leads to high testosterone. High insulin and high testosterone lead to not ovulating, and not ovulating is often the root problem with infertility. Not ovulating and too low of progesterone levels lead to missed periods. So missed periods are a big symptom of PCOS that indicate the deeper root problem of insulin resistance. Well, insulin's not always high in PCOS, but most of the time. Estimates for insulin resistance in PCOS run maybe 60% up to 95%. So practically, we can basically assume that most women in PCOS have some sort of insulin resistance problem. The solution to PCOS is also complicated. I've heard that a lot of doctors may not be willing to touch it. And I can understand that because maybe they haven't had much success in treating PCOS patients. The ultimate solution, though, is to find a doctor who is willing to try and help. I know a lot of hormone optimization specialists, and many of them have a lot of experience in treating women in PCOS. They want to help you optimize all your hormones. That means bringing down your levels of insulin, which ultimately reduces your levels of testosterone. It also means bringing up your levels of thyroid, especially one thyroid hormone called T3. A little side note about T3 hormones. Doctors know that a process converts one of the thyroid hormones, T4, into another thyroid hormone, T3. But women in PCOS may not be able to make that conversion quite as well. It's called deiodination. So sometimes a commonly used thyroid medication called levothyroxine just isn't enough, and a woman may need a different type of thyroid replacement in PCOS. Raising those thyroid levels and lowering insulin can help increase insulin sensitivity, which is also called reversing insulin resistance. Increasing insulin sensitivity makes insulin levels go down and also helps encourage ovulation and indirectly infertility. If you ovulate more often, hopefully every month, you're less likely to have fertility problems and you're going to naturally have higher levels of progesterone. Solving insulin resistance can help make testosterone levels go down as well. Even though PCOS is complex, there are providers who know exactly what to do to help you if you have PCOS. So here are the steps that I'd recommend you take. First of all, if you're struggling with missed periods, weight gain, infertility, and you suspect or maybe you know that you might have PCOS, visit my website and fill out my patient referral request form. I can't guarantee I know a provider in your town, but I can give it my best shot. I'll try to find somebody with the training and expertise to be able to help you feel like yourself again. Get all your hormones, your testosterone, your thyroid, your progesterone, and your insulin optimized by one of those hormone specialists. Well, you're probably going to need to make some diet changes, but it'll ultimately be worth it. Whether you have a PCOS provider or not, I might be able to help you with some of that insulin resistance, which will also help a lot. If you are a hormone optimization specialist, I'd love to get you on my hormone provider database. Click the link that says join my database and I'll see if I can hook you up with some patients in your area. Again, I can't guarantee anything because I don't know where you are or where the patients might be, but I'll give it my best shot. Thanks so much for watching. If you like this video, if you found it helpful, click the like and subscribe buttons so you get notified whenever I post a new one. We'll look forward to talking to you again next time.